Diego, and I am here with Hayden James.
What's up?
What's going on? I really am excited to talk to you about your music. Before getting into your newest album, Between Us, I kind of want to take a trip down memory lane a little bit.
Sure.
Okay, cool. So, Something About You. That's probably one of my favorite songs that you've ever composed.
Thank you.
Is it about somebody in particular?
It's a lot of my music is written for particular people, but Something About You is not. It's just a general feel.
It's like a general overall feeling.
Definitely.
So yeah, what made you want to create that song?
So I was working with a good friend of mine, George Maple, and we were going back and forth on different top lines and things, and one day we kind of just that happened really quickly. And I was listening to, at the time, a bit of Zoo and Tame Impala, people like that. And it's just kind of inspired by that. And off it went. It was pretty quick process.
Right. I mean, you've done remixes for Bob Moses. And I know you reference Rufus Du Sol a lot. Are these people that are inspirations to you when it comes to creating?
100%. Yeah. Yeah. Just their tones, what the instruments they use. I'm good friends with the guys as well. So, yeah, definitely. It's an Australian vibe for sure. Yeah.
Permission to Love. So this is about your wife.
That's right. So this is about someone. Yeah.
So this one actually, Something About You isn't about a you, but
it's about
Permission
everyone.
To Love is about your wife.
That's right. Yeah. So I went and asked her parents for permission for me to ask her to marry me. And that night I got back into the studio and wrote that song. So yeah.
And
pretty special one.
Did you present the song to her parents hey, can I marry my wife? Or am I allowed to ask my girlfriend to marry me?
Yeah,
it was
a respect
song as a present?
Oh, no. I wrote it right after. So I asked them, they're like, yes, we love you, blah, blah, blah. And then I wrote it after the fact. So, it's just an outpour of emotion. Yeah.
Did you guys play it at your wedding?
No, we didn't play that one at our wedding. I hear my music all the time and perform it. So I'm like, no, Hayden.
don't. Yeah. That's so funny, because I feel like if I were to ask if I was going to have a boyfriend to ask my parents, I would love them to write a song. That would be...
Have you got a boyfriend? I can write something.
You know what? I might be hitting you up for that one day. So, Better Together went gold, and Just Friends is double platinum.
Yes.
But you've been one of those artists that hasn't really, struggled in remaining consistent. I feel like you come out with a single, and then, you're not rushing to come out with the next song. You let that song sit.
Yeah, exactly. That's
so this
right.
is kind of a big overall album that you've composed. This has probably taken a lot of time.
It has taken a lot of time. It's taken a couple of years, depending on which song we're talking about. Yeah, there's been a couple that have taken 2-3 years. It's really, really great to get a whole album out there instead of just singles, because, just for fans to listen to something that's just a little more, just a little bigger. So, yeah.
Yeah, right. And so you started a Between Us series, and it kind of talks and delves deeper into each song that's on the album.
Yeah.
I really want you to talk about one of your favorite songs on your new album and kind of the creation process behind that song.
Yeah. Well, one of my favorites is called Between Us, which is the title track. And that's one that probably took the longest to write. We'd written, me and Jarrah from Panama, had written maybe 3 or 4 different versions of it. Nothing was kind of sitting. We left it for about a year. And then I got back to it and started playing some different keys, which is what you hear now on the record. And then I got Jarrah to sing some more verses, and it started coming together. It's a special one because it kind of encompasses the whole idea of the record and different phases of relationships that people go through. So yeah, that's probably my favorite one.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And so this is the biggest piece of work you've released to date, and it's more of a lifestyle album. I think that you need to listen to it in its entirety.
Absolutely.
Well, I think it's a lifestyle album, and you need to listen to it in its entirety, not just different songs that are pieced
100%.
Together.
That was my whole idea, from track one. I want someone to be able to listen to the whole thing, the whole way through, and not skip. Yeah, really important for me.
Yeah, and I don't mean to compare albums but when Odessa came out with A Moment Apart, I felt that was one of those albums that you need to listen to completely through before finding your favorite song, but you can listen to it completely through. And
That's
I think
right.
the same goes for your newest album.
Yeah, thank you.
Was that intentional?
100%. That's why it took so long as well. It's I probably had 20, 30 demos, and I just picked these 11 because I told the right story at the right time and kind of flowed together as well.
Yeah, and so your music has always been portrayed as a very peaceful, airy, and kind of summery aesthetic. So where do you usually go to make your music?
Well, I live in Sydney by the beach, which is very similar to San Diego where we are now. So it's I have a studio in a house that I live in, probably like 10 minutes from the beach. And yeah, I just spend a lot of time outdoors and hanging out and swimming. So that's the kind of vibe, I guess, you get from my music.
Yeah, and what's the hardest thing for you, like, about creating music?
It's deciding, it's probably deciding what I want to say in the music, and I just take a long time. I'm a perfectionist, so it's take a long time to figure out what the song should be and how people will perceive it and things like that. But yeah, it takes time, but I think it's totally worth it in the end.
Yeah, and so you're kind of starting your newest track, and this is your tour that you're going to be doing and embarking on with your newest music.
Mm-hmm.
Where have you gone thus far?
So we actually started at a festival called Splendor in the Grass, which is in Byron Bay in New South Wales. And then after that, I did an Australian tour. It was my biggest one yet, which is just amazing. We did a couple of dates in Melbourne and Sydney, went to Brisbane and Perth as well as a couple of dates in New Zealand. And now I'm here in the US, so here for 4 weeks.
Right. Okay. Do you have any funny tour stories that you can share with us?
I actually have one tour story from CrossFest last year. Yeah.
I love CrossFest. Yes, I'm so happy that you're bringing that up.
Yeah, it's my favorite place to play. So, okay, so I came off stage after playing the main stage, and I had, like, the cool box with all my drinks and stuff in there, and I opened it up, and someone had shat in the cool box. So it was like a poo.
Wait, they pooped in your cooler?
Yes.
In your cooler?
Yes. Like, I still don't know who it was.
Did you eat the food after?
No. Did you? No.
That's very distasteful. Did you find out who did it? Like,
no.
Was this a...
I know. I was like, it would have been another band, like someone I knew.
It had to have been. This must have been like a joke or a ploy. Like, they wanted to have you kind of get a rise out of you.
Yeah.
If I were you, I would have been like looking for them. Like, who's the culprit?
We kind of did. We were trying to figure it out, but yeah, we didn't end up finding out who it was. But anyway, Crossed. I loved playing at Crossed, but yeah, that was a weird